Welcome back to another episode of the Course Creation Incubator. I'm Gina Onativia, your course coach, digital strategist, and course bulldog, here to help make sure your course gets done, marketed, and out to the world. Now, I've never been a big girly girl. I was a huge tomboy when I was a kid. I played soccer, lacrosse, ran around, wild hair, the whole bit. If I put in a brown beret, I was getting a little bit fancy. It was that kind of childhood. And as I got older, I wanted to learn more about, well, being pretty. Finally learning how to curl my hair, pick out great outfits, how to compliment my body and feel really good when I stepped out in public as a course coach and digital strategist. When I had questions, I turned to this gorgeous lady, Alma Barrero, who is inside of my course mastermind. Now, Alma is the kind of girl you want to be friends with because she's always upbeat, she's always positive, and love is definitely her driving force. Like, if you look at her website, proud wife, devoted mama, a sassy Spanish optimist, it's right there, right? Living my best life in Sydney, Australia. She's someone you want to get to know and hang out with. So years ago, Alma started giving me tips on what outfits to wear, how to feel more confident. And she really awakened something inside of me to see colors and fabric and clothes in a different way. Now, like so many things, so many areas of my life, I'm definitely a work in progress. But the more I teach course creators about branding, the more I realize how important the fashion side is. You're going to hear Alma talk all about it. And listen, it's not just about fashion. It's about having confidence, feeling good, putting your best self forward. And I think we all want a bit of that. So let's listen into Alma to get a sense of our own style power. Alma, welcome to the podcast. So excited. I can see you right now. I know you guys can't see her, but I'm excited to see you because it's been years since I saw your beautiful face.
Yep, that's right. I'm so excited to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
Okay, let's dive in because we've got style questions and that's why you're here. So first and foremost, lots of first-time course creators maybe they haven't thought about their style yet, right? Maybe they're working 9-to-5s and they've thought a little bit about it, but now they're at the forefront, right? They're experts. And why is it so important to your brand to think about the style and your wardrobe and what you're representing?
Well, you brought a really good point. Like many times we don't even realize on what we're wearing on our everyday life until we realize that we're going to be seen on camera or we're going to be seen. But the funny fact is that we're being seen all the time, whether it's by ourselves or by anybody else, we're seen all the time. But there is that thing about knowing that you're going to be in front of a camera that is like, oh my God, all eyes on me, right? So right. I think that's a really good tip and a really good hint to realize that maybe there is something weak, like there might be a disconnection between getting dressed and showing who we really are. And that's where I get super excited. Okay. Cause when you look at getting dressed as an outcome to really knowing who you are, then getting dressed becomes part of your life in a way that it's just like a self-expression, okay? And it doesn't matter what you wear, you feel seen. And you feel seen for who you are, and you don't care so much about what interpretations others make, because that's just the reflection of who you truly are.
Okay, all right, I love this. So the sense that we're connecting now, and a lot of times creating a course is the impetus behind this, right? Like where you realize, oh, how am I seen? How do I want to be seen, right? What is my identity? So and I was talking to you before we started here that I had a couple of people come up to me during the last class of 6-week accelerator and say, well, do you have any tips for what we should wear or how we should represent ourselves? And I was like, oh, I got to bring Alma on the podcast. So what's a good place to start when you're thinking about how does what I dress or how I dress represent who I am?
Okay, so I always say the basic, and for me, the most impactful point where to start from is color. Mm-hmm. So it's realizing what colors really feed your soul. Like what are those colors that people like you wear? So for instance, I'm wearing yellow today. And when I wear this shade of yellow, everybody's like, oh my God, that is so you. and not that other people define like who you are or how, or what looks good on you, but there are certain colors that you're just like, know that those colors are for you. And there is a little difference between wearing a color trying to hide you and then wearing a color that really channels that personality of yours. So my first point is always have fun with color, because that's what attracts the eye. And noticing where you feel more attracted, if to warm colors or cool. And there is no chance here. Like that doesn't happen for a chance. Like if your personality is much warmer and you love connecting with people, wearing a warm color, it's going to transmit that. And that'll be translated into a coherent message into other people's eyes. Where if you're cooler, if you approach in a different way, like when you have a much cooler personality, you probably don't go like all over like people, like all of a sudden, you know, like you just wait, observe. You have another way to come about about anything, right? So a cool color will translate that much more. But that doesn't mean that you need to use like a really boring gray that is going to hide you. There are so many vibrant and beautiful cool colors that also will harmonize with that with that what is your real essence.
So how do I figure out the color that really works for me? Like, should I just be testing different ones out, like trying different things on and seeing what resonates with me?
Yes. So okay. I've got a book coming out, and oh, that's yeah. gonna help with that a lot, because I'm giving like in the bonus resources, I'm giving the tool that is gonna help you figure that out.
Love it. Okay.
But the bottom line of it all is where you feel more seen. Okay. That's the ultimate key. And that's why I love color so much, because you have two choices: using color to be the center of the stage, mm-hmm. or using color to make you the protagonist. And that's what we want, especially on video, right? Like we want people to feel attracted to looking at your face, not what you're wearing, right? So I'm moving here and people are just listening, but anyway. So when you stand in front of a mirror, like try to pull two different garments, like one that is warmer, like a orange, like or yellow, and one okay. that is more pink, blue. And look, I've done this experiment so many times, and it feels funny, but even just taking a picture and looking at it several times during the day, realize what color helps your eye to go straight to your face, and what color does the different effect. Like, and it's really not that complicated. When we overthink it, that's where the problem is.
Okay. All right. So color, we're going to try different things. I love what you said about eyes straight to your face. What other considerations are a good place to start? Like what other questions should we be asking ourselves? Like cut or type of clothing we like, anything. Like I'm wearing a halter. I'm actually a little embarrassed right now because I didn't consciously think to myself, well, Alma's coming on. I should probably put like a hot outfit on, even though you guys can't see it. But so I'm wearing a halter right now, and I wear a lot of these shirts because I want to show off my arms, right?
Exactly. So, yeah. Exactly. And I love that you're bringing out this point, because so many people tell me this and I'm like, okay, you've got pressure. How about me? And you know what? Ultimately, what I always say is that it's not about what you wear, but how you feel wearing it. That's the most important thing. I really don't care if it's a plain white t-shirt or if it's whatever, like whatever, it does not matter what it is, the piece that you're wearing, but how you feel wearing it. Because if you feel excited to show off your muscles, okay, that's going to come through. Whereas if you're wearing something that you're like, I'm not really sure if this is for me, what are they going to say? Of course, people are going to see it, and even more on camera, because guess what? Like, even on camera, people can like forward or rewind or whatever, and they can see your body language much better. And that is subconscious messaging. So that's the, it would come very close to color when I say you need to feel excited about wearing that piece. It's not about the piece itself. It's how you feel wearing it. That's how you want to focus on. And I tell my clients every morning when you wake up, have a little glimpse of how you want to feel and then choose that piece. But like, don't try to fake it, and don't try to make it the other way around, because I don't believe that's how you are going to energetically impact the way you want to make an impact.
Okay, I love it. And I always think in terms of how do I want to feel today? And then who's my audience today too? So because so today I had a series of meetings and I wanted to show off my arms, but then I've been doing a couple of trainings for a more conservative group. So, and the woman I'm training with said to me, my friend was like, you should cover your arms. I'm like, I never would have thought about that. And so I still wanted to feel good. So I picked something that was a little tight on the arms that like accentuated my body, but I still wanted to feel like me. Right.
Beautiful. Yeah. I love that. And you brought up a really good point, especially when you are on camera. I really like pieces that are closer to your body, so they don't add up extra volume that we don't really need, especially on camera.
So let me ask you about that, because, okay, my love handles are a source of despair and concern sometimes. I know, you guys, she's scrunching her face right now. Like, no. But sometimes I'm like, oh, maybe I shouldn't wear a tight shirt around that area. But then I also feel like if I let the fabric flow, that just makes me look bigger, right? So maybe I should just get over it and accept it and just go with it.
No. Okay. So no.
No. No.
The key here is the weight of the fabric. Because we can, okay. So I call it a style game. Okay. And this is all visual, right? When it comes to 3D, like, perception of what we're wearing, this is just a visual game. Okay. And the fabrics that you wear are very important, because they all have different weights, and wearing volume with different fabrics will make a different effect. Okay. So I'm going to give you an example. I've got a bone structure that is like medium big. Okay. So if I wear volume, but it's with fabrics that are very light, the weight of that fabric doesn't harmonize with my natural structure. Let's put it that way. Okay. So that volume is going to look really funny on me. Instead, if you use a fabric that harmonizes with your whole structure, so for instance, you, Gina, like you, like if I were to paint you on a canvas, I would paint you with a finer stroke. Whereas if I was to paint myself, I would paint myself with a thicker stroke. Okay. Just to give you like a more artistic idea of where I'm talking. So the weight of the fabric is very important. And also the way you play with color as well. Okay. So if you use that volume in an area that you don't want the eye to go to, just use a color that won't pop as much as another one that you're going to use to bring the eye to where you want to go. Okay. So we want to disguise any volume in your midriff, for instance. Okay. So you can choose to wear a looser top and then wear like a nice scarf bright that will bring the eye up. And when I say scarf, it can be like earrings or lipstick, a nice necklace, anything that brings the eye up and doesn't stop the eye in the area that you maybe don't want to bring the attention to. So that's what I mean when I say style is just a visual game and you can play with it.
Okay, that's awesome. Even just that tip is huge and something for me to keep in mind that I don't even think about. And so we mentioned about filming. We've got course creators who have filmed, like say they're filming a 5-module course, okay? And I say switch up your outfits. It doesn't have to be every module. But it's nice to just change it up visually. Like you're right, you're playing a visual game. That overwhelms people. Like, how do I pick out those different outfits to represent me on my course? Do you have any tips for us to figure that out?
You really don't have to complicate it. Like, okay, you can even wear the same t-shirt and change the jacket. You can wear the same top and change the accessories. You can change the hair if you're a woman. It really doesn't have that complicated, but I agree with you. If you wear a different outfit with each module, I believe that it will benefit the one who is receiving the course, because it's like, oh, okay, we are now in another phase. It's like reinforcing your post-it system, right? It's like, yes, reinforcing that we are in the next step, and also reinforcing that they are moving forward. So I do like that. But also, of course, we are all different. And I think ultimately it all goes with the personality of the person who is showing up on camera, right? And if they're like, no way, I just want to show that I'm the same every day, then awesome. Like, I don't think they should fake it. But on the other side, I would highly recommend it.
I would highly recommend it too. And like, that's a tip for photo shoots too, right? So instead of changing your outfit completely, add a necklace, add a jacket, and I gotta start doing that. Okay, mental note for that. That's great. That's awesome. So we've been doing a lot of Zoom calls, okay? Like, so not as much in person, a lot of Zoom calls. I've got to imagine you've got tips for dressing differently than being on Zoom versus being live in person.
Yeah, I love Zoom. Because you only have to figure out like 1/4 of your body. It's that simple. And this is another point where color is really important, because it will show a lot who you are. Key, and I know so many people say this, light is the most important thing when it comes to Zoom. And I even have like this ring light. I don't have it here today because I'm using natural light, but you know, even ring lights have little panels that are warmer or cooler. Yeah. Just figure out which one goes better with your natural complexion, because that would also reinforce a lot. And you don't, like, if you're a woman, you don't even have to wear makeup when you wear that, you know, it's like, whatever, yeah, I'm just showing up for myself. So if you're a man also, but I would say that's the cool thing about Zoom. And what I like about Zoom also is that you can play with necklines. Okay, so a really cool thing about necklines is that when you are able to frame your face, just repeating the same shape, even the lower part of your face, when you repeat it on your neckline, whereas if it's with a necklace of with your neckline, that will help the other person to look much more easily to your face, which is what we want.
Oh, okay.
And if you're a woman, I highly recommend red lipstick in your own kind of red, because it's in the early days, when I started in this field, it was said that a red lipstick for women was perceived subconsciously as a tie for men. So I like putting red lipstick on has some magical powers on women. Like, and some people are so scared, like, this is so not me. But I just want to say there are so many kinds of reds. Like, there are so many shades, there are so many intensities. And of course it doesn't have to be red, but lipstick helps to be heard and listened to.
How do we feel about hot pink? That's my jam. So I wear like a really hot pink
look. Of course you do. Of course you do. Yeah. And because you would look good in hot pink. I'm not a hot pink one. I'm red because I'm warmer, but I would definitely see you in a hot pink for sure.
I got your endorsement. That's great. So I love all these tips, Alma, and I need more. And you've got a book coming out. So tell us about the book and what we can learn from it.
I'm so excited. This is coming finally to the world. This book is the result of my last 11 years of experience helping others empower themselves with what they were. And this book is just giving you permission to show up whatever the hell you want, but feeling reassured that you are showing up as yourself. So this, it's called Style Power, and it's got a three-step formula. It's called the Style Power Formula. and it's designed to take you from identifying what makes your soul alive and what makes you feel you and feel at home, to translating that into clothes. We have a whole personality style categorization to help you identify better what it is that makes you you. Also, a different identity profile system that helps you understand why you feel so stuck when you go and try to choose pieces in front of your closet. And then, of course, all these tips that we've been sharing here, even more, like to maximize this style game and understand that this is all about making you the protagonist of your own life and show up proud with pride of like of understanding and owning and embracing that you are the way you are and you look the way you look in this lifetime for a reason and making the most of that.
Okay, this is a must have. Everyone listening right now, I need this book. I cannot wait. And everyone, as a course creator, you are an expert and you are putting yourself out there. We need this style guide, Style Power. So we'll link to it in the show notes. If you pre-order, I know there's a little bonus, right? To get a meditation with that. Okay.
Yes. So,
and we need that as well. We need everything we can from Alma. So we're going to pick up that book. We're going to check it out in the show notes. And thank you so much for coming by. This is just the tip of the iceberg, I know, in terms of what we can do with our bodies and with wardrobe and with fashion. So we'll have to have you back, Alma, to talk more.
Thank you so much. It was so much fun. Thank you.
It's not about what you wear, but how you feel wearing it. I feel like talking to Alma is one huge pep talk covered in chocolate. Please, please, please check out her new book, Style Power. Click on the link on the show notes and buy it now. I hope you enjoyed our chat, and I'll see you next week for more course creation tips and insights. Please rate and review this episode, especially if you're listening on Apple Podcasts, and subscribe. I would love to get the word out about this podcast to the course creator community. Until next week, go create, be you and be brilliant, and get it done.